What's up guys, so today I'm going to be working on the IS300. I'm going to be chasing a front suspension like noise. It's making kind of like a clunking or clicking noise whenever I turn the steering wheel left and right when I'm not moving or even at low speeds. I'm suspecting that it could be one of the front wheel bearings. It's on the driver's side, or it also could be one of the bushings for the suspension arms and links. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and drive the car around to show you guys what the sound sounds like, and I'm gonna go ahead and take off the wheel, inspect everything, and today I'm probably gonna take off the the spindle and take it to like a shop so they can replace it. I do have the parts for the wheel bearings here. I got it from Rock Auto, so yeah, that's what we're gonna be doing today. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and back out of my driveway, and you can probably hear it when I do that because, yeah, it's always there whenever I'm like turning or moving at low speeds. So yeah. Okay. So I just drove my car around and it's not making a noise, which is super irritating because I know for a fact that it does it all the time, but it doesn't want to do it now. I don't know why, maybe because of the cold weather. What the fuck? But yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and just take a look at the suspension. I've done it like a bunch of times already, but I'm gonna take a look again, look at the brakes, and see what's up.
Turn my headphone down a little bit. Yeah. You got shot a lot. How many niggas you shot a lot? How many times did you ride a lot? How many niggas done die a lot? How many times did you cheat a lot?
Okay, car's up now, but I forgot to break the lug nuts loose, so I'm just gonna go ahead and wedge some wood here so the tire doesn't spin or the wheel doesn't spin. Should be good to go.
Every day that I'm alive, I'ma ride with this stick. I'd rather be broke in jail than be dead and rich. Told my brothers take my breath if I turn to a snitch. But I'm 21 for L, ain't no way I'ma switch.
Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and take the brake caliper off so that I can look at the brake pads, because I know I didn't check them when I first bought the car, so they could be worn out. So it's just gonna be the 14 millimeter socket here, and then you should probably turn the steering wheel so that it's easier to access these bolts. Okay, I got the brake caliper off. It's a little rusty, but it should be fine. I don't think it's seized or anything, but I do have extra calipers on the side when I do a brake refresh, and the brake pads, they're alright still. There's a little bit of meat left, but there's no problems with them. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take off this caliper bracket so I can get the rotor off. It's just 217 mil. Jeez, it's dark. 217 mil back there, and it should come right off. Okay, I got the rotor off, and everything looks good. And when I spin the wheel bearing, or if I shake it, there's not much play. But I know for a fact that there is a whining, grinding noise whenever I'm driving. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take it off anyway and take it to the shop. I think it's the hardest part is taking off or detaching it from the upper lower ball joint and the tie rod. Okay, I got all the cotter pins out, and I sprayed some PB Blaster on all of the castle nuts so the outer tie rod end and the lower ball joint, they're both aftermarket Moog ball joints. So they both came with a 19 millimeter castle nut, and the OEM castle nut on the upper control arm is a 17 millimeter. So I'm gonna go ahead and break those loose and use the ball joint puller to get everything off. Okay, so this is a ball joint puller, pusher, removal tool thingy, and how it works is basically gonna use the jaws and it's gonna go around the knuckle or spindle, and then that center shaft is gonna go ahead and push the ball joint out. Yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and set this up and then see how it works. So as you can see, that's like super violent. I got the outer tie rod out, and I'm just gonna do the same thing to the upper ball joint and lower ball joint. Pro tip, keep the outer tie rod attached while you do the upper and lower ball joints so that the spindle doesn't turn. And before you remove the spindle, there is an ABS sensor right there. You have to remove that before you move the spindle. So that is gonna be a 10 millimeter bolt. Okay, so I got the spindle off. Again, the wheel bearing, there's no play and it's not making any weird noises when I spin it by hand, but when I drive, I think it's the wheel bearing making noises. The lower ball joint, I just replaced that when I first got the car, and it seems pretty good so far. Doesn't seem like there's anything wrong with the outer tie rod because I replaced that as well. And the upper ball joint, it's still good as well. So it's either some of the suspension bushings. I already tried to disconnect the sway bar end link to see if there was a sway bar making any noises. So hopefully it is the wheel bearing and I won't have to deal with the noises anymore. Okay, since my car is not drivable right now, we're gonna go ahead and use the Celica. Oh God, it's fucking hot. Oh, no brakes. Still starts up like a champ. There's no power steering, it's leaking. So I'm gonna fill up power steering and also fill up brake fluid because my brake pedal is going to the floor. Okay, so I got everything loaded up and I'm gonna go ahead to Midas to try to see if they can press my bearing out and press the new one in. Okay, change of plans. I just got home from two shops. The first one said they can do it, but they wanted me to get another hub. But I only bought the wheel bearing that's inside, the snap ring, and also the wheel seal. So they wanted me to get another hub to replace it. And the second shop, they weren't gonna replace it because I bought my own parts and they don't do that. So I guess what I'm gonna just do is just put it back for now and see if I can get the hub in the future, or maybe just another whole spindle assembly. Working backwards, guys. So when you're finally tightening everything down, you wanna make sure that you torque everything to the factory specifications. Holy crap, it's blurry. But the outer tie rod to the steering knuckle is 40 foot-pounds. The lower ball joint is gonna be 90 foot-pounds, and the upper ball joint is 50 foot-pounds. So I'm gonna go ahead and use a torque wrench for all that. Okay, I put the brake caliper back on. So the caliper bracket bolt that attaches the bracket to the knuckle is gonna be 87 foot-pounds. And the caliper insulation bolt right here, there's two of them, they're gonna be 25 foot-pounds. Lastly, don't forget to put the speed sensor back and tighten the bolt. Hand tighten should be just enough. You don't wanna tighten that too much. So guys, I just went around the block for a drive, and the clunking noise and the squealing noise is still there, so messing around with the brakes didn't help. I'm pretty sure it's the wheel bearing, but I couldn't get around to that today because of parts. So save that for another video. And yeah, I guess that's it. Thanks for watching. Sorry for if it was very uneventful today, but yeah, hopefully my videos will get better in the future. So stay tuned and see you guys in the next video.
Everybody got their thing. Some niggas make millions, other niggas make memes. I'm on a money routine. I don't want smoke, I want cream. I don't want no more comparisons, this is a marathon, and I'm aware I've been playing a bet from a lack of promotions. I never was one for the bragging and boasting. I guess I was hoping the music would speak for itself, but the people want everything else. Okay, no problem, I show up on every one album, you know what the outcome